as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Through the mercy of God, rest in peace.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread, forgive us our trespasses.
Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners. Now and at the hour of our death, Amen.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning.
Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
और मृत्यु विजेता है अब सदा सर्वदा और अनंत काल तक।
आमीन।
एकां शक्ति जोर करो जीवन ज्योति दान करो
न्याय मुक्ति पापों से न्याय विधि से बचाए तेरे नश्वर भक्तों को
मिटा दे तेरी अनुग्रह हमें संभाले तू ही जीवन दाता और मृत्यु विजेता है तू ही जीवन का आधार तथा आत्मा का आशा केंद्र है अब सब सदा सर्वद और अनंत का
स्वीकार करना प्रभु और मेरा विश्वास पूर्वक सामने तेरे दासों का बलिदान
विश्वास पूर्वक सामने तेरे दासों का बलिदान सारा
नो अब्राहम इसहाक का पावन बलिदान
and MA English Literature from SNDP University, Mumbai. and joined the congregation at Thrissur on 15th June 1969 and professed on 5th May 1971 and took the name of Anil Kosi and made her perpetual commitment. Kosi served in the diocese of Sagar, Meerut, Kalyan, Bijnor, Rajkot and Agra. She served the congregation in the capacities of provincial counselor. The Hindi medium school in the diocese of Bijnor, where she was principal for 16 years, profoundly proclaims it now. No wonder in this. Her mastery over the languages of Hindi and English made her to translate many of to the entrusted duty. Love for the congregation made sister eternal in our memories. She boldly proclaimed through her life the message to the coming generation to be docile to the Holy Spirit and trust in the divine providence in all we do and act. Sister was suffering from pneumonia from June 2020 and was under treatment at St. Mary's Hospital, Najibabad. She was discharged when she recovered and she was resuming her duties in the convent. Again, when she felt uneasiness in the month of August, she was admitted in the hospital on 17th August 2020 and treatment was going on. When it was diagnosed as double pneumonia and her lungs were damaged, she was shifted to Holy Family Hospital, Okala on 20th August 2020 for better treatment. There she showed some improvement to our surprise, but she again was administered to her 31st August by Father Shuri, the Assistant Director of Holy Family Hospital. At 12 noon on 1st September 2020, she calmly laid. Dear Sister Tosi, you are a pillar of our province. Your books in Hindi brought many souls to the Lord. Your timely jokes and fun will be always remembered. We love you, Sister. May the doors of heaven be open to receive your soul.
Yeah. They rejoice in the coming of your glory, and together with the brothers and sisters, they delight in the everlasting happiness of your kingdom. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
St. Paul to Corinthians, chapter 15, verses 20 to 28. But the truth is that Christ has been raised from death as a guarantee that those who sleep in death will also be raised. For just as death came by means of man, in the same way, the rising from death comes by means of a man. For just as all people die because of their union with Adam, in the same way, all will be raised to life because of their union with Christ. But each one will be raised in his proper order. Christ, first of all, then at the time of his coming, those who belong to him. When the end will come, Christ will overcome all spiritual rulers, authorities, and power. For Christ must rule until God defeats all enemies and puts them under his feet. The last enemy to be defeated, God puts all things under his feet. It is clear, of course, that the words "all things" do not include God himself. Christ rule, then he himself, the Son, will place himself under God, who placed all things under him. And God will rule completely.
Good vocations.
That's what happens to me. I speak very well. Most of this conference. And he also added, for a good person, for a good sleep, softest pillow is a good conscience. Good conscience. This is the physical way of speaking and rising. But the mystical language of both first reading and the second, if you sleep and rise, rise with it. Knowledge of encountering Christ, dead and risen, probably he was also directly instrumental of proving the death of Christ, just as he did. Persecuting Christians, once he encountered the truth of the risen Lord, nothing kept him back. You know the testimony of Paul. And Jesus' words are hard to believe. My encounter with the Buddhists, belief, mind, faith, they always raise a huge finger. You Christians are meeting us. And this is eat the flesh and drink the blood. Little words mean something. But the mystical understanding of the words, knowing and doing the will of the Father is my food. Eating the body of Christ is the food. Drinking the blood is the drink. It has a mystical connotation. Why I'm explaining this word of God is so precious and sacred. Starts with vibrating in our eyes and ears and thinking. So, taking these thoughts in mind, connecting it, the person's concentrated. There's something of the mystical that one begins the journey of committing one's life to God. There's something of the mystical not seen, but deep within experienced, the formator's facility. Personal prayer throws light on it, and one's own ups and downs of life, little doubt, certainty, uncertainty, reveals to us what does it really mean to commit one's life to God. In the psalm, somewhere, you commit your life to God, God commits himself to you to take care of you, to act on your behalf. Is my food. And this is what happens to a consecrated person. Knowing that God has called and acting the way God would have acted, the way Jesus would have acted, that makes his missionary brother smiling. And sister, Rosie, and not in the room, she had a smiling face. She was a cheerful giver. Smiling, age, sickness, suffering, don't make up it. She was a source of inspiration to many of us, so therefore, what happened tonight, so I'm all the patients, both of you, something at 10:30. Are all fine, yes, everybody is fine, but somebody is not so fine. That very night, sister, there are these people that said to me, she might have been put on ventilator. There was bothering me. I said that one sister, Nadiva, did not, Sister Frosty, Sister Frosty was diagnosed. I know, but he brought me in, he said. That again, reminds me the effectivity of the consecrated person. Versus lower high, poor or rich, we have an approach of encountering the truth of God and revealing the joy of knowing the truth, and putting people on the path of truth, and leading people the truth that makes them clean. So all doubts, anxieties, fears, sins and sorrow, death. You know your word? Death is a powerful word that leads us to find out sorrow. Yet, Jesus, in Jesus we die, in Jesus we rise. We therefore renew our own conviction. Life is a journey. It permeates into eternity. Death is accidental happening. Cause, sickness, then finally heart beats. Beats for the Creator. And our rests in the Creator is our rest instead. Ask my heart in restless for O Lord, I'll keep rest in you. And Sister Claus, you can imagine her at the photograph she was smiling. And she is resting in peace in the Lord. So when Jesus rested for 3 days, third day he rose again. Today is the second day as we go through the ritual of the final rites. Many are praying for us. The one who served Christ, our children, and promoters, many parts of our country. And this is not the last prayer we do, but we continue to pray for her. And in her, our intentions will always be raised in her prayer, in her intercession, and she will send down many more blessings for the growth of our missions. What made her happy, perhaps, is the fulfillment of the mission that was entrusted to her. She did it wholeheartedly, with no condition. I still remember discussing about the translation of Entire's life. I began to look at her. Are you really able to do? I didn't ask her. My mind was questioning. She answered me. I didn't ask her. Are you able to translate this? I have done her much Hindi, she said. And she brought me a complimentary copy. This is what I'm saying. Even the impossible, apparently, but it makes it possible. So her contribution to the missions, not in here. Different parts of our country, and particularly many fathers are vibrating with a good word in the campuses, even campus. She moved around a bit because of works of compassion, friend of the poor, at the same time, good in relationship with everybody. So, her name is transparent, therefore, her transparent life may always be an example as she transparently reports herself to the Creator, the one who creates us without our consent, he calls us without our consent. So God's will, therefore, our sad, sorrowful hearts, they rejoice in God's own consolation, the near and dear ones who would have loved to be here, perhaps we make up for them. Here, the nearest, the dearest ones, for her, as in the missionary dimension, she has been eating the flesh, renewed her blood. That we do now on her behalf, she has been doing it regularly. When the good religious misses Holy Mass, misses every good of that day. Often it not in her mass, we now have no individual, but I spent 2 hours before the Blessed Sacrament. I have heard people sometimes missing Holy Mass, 2 hours before the Blessed Sacrament. Spiritually eating and drinking, the Holy Eucharist is inviting us to believe utterly in what Jesus went through, and we rise every morning to sleep every night, sleeping and rising, praising the Lord. So, he cares for us, and then we multiply. God says you may have many more desires to accomplish. Her desires turn out to be inspirations to many, and young vocations may draw inspiration. Complete the works she would have liked to complete. So that is a challenge to us. May God bless you. Mr. Coffey, you will return your rest in the religious Holy Mass today. Added merits to growth, to faith, and your inner strength to give our sanctity of life, and to contribute, make our contribution towards the saving mission of our Savior. Believe in utterly. You are our Creator, Father. You provide us all that we are in need of. To the Master of creation, we offer our prayers in faith. Lord, hear our prayer.
Leaders, especially our Holy Father, Pope Francis, and our Archbishop, Albert D'Souza, Reverend Father Rafi, the parish priest, and all the fathers who are at this altar, to offer this sacrifice. Fill them with your word and spirit and make them powerful instruments of your kingdom. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
God our Father, your power brings us life on this earth. Those who die still live in your presence. Their lives change but do not end. We pray and commend to you our dear sister Annie Flossie, your servant. all the innumerable blessings we have received through her. In your mercy and love, blot out the sins she has committed through human weakness and let her live with you forever. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Into your hands, O Lord, we humbly embrace our sister Annie closely. In this life, you embraced her with your tender love. Deliver her now from every evil and bid her to enter eternal rest. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord,
into your heart, Sister Annie closely worked hard to commendable contribution to the church. Welcome her into the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, our sister Annie Flossy is gone now from this earthly dwelling and has left behind those who mourn in her absence. Especially, we pray for her family members, relatives, friends and all her dear and near ones. Sister Sissy Claire, her own sister, who is in the Tanzania mission, who are unable to be present here to pay the last homage to her. Grant neither for what we have lost, nor in regret for the past, but always in hope of the eternal kingdom, where you will bring us together again. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, gratefully we remember and commend to you all her spiritual directors, confessors, benefactors, her community members, all our sisters. Bless them with your peace and joy and with your loving presence. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, we pray for all the departed souls of our parents, benefactors, our sisters, and very specially the departed parents of our sister Annie Flossy, who brought her up and generously offered her to the service of the church. And also, we remember her departed brother. In company with Christ who died and now lives, may they rejoice in your kingdom where all our tears are wiped away. Unite us together again in one family to sing your praises.